diet and prostate cancer is a big, big, big topic. So what we know with diet is it does play a role in the development as well as the progression of prostate cancer. It's interesting what we found over the last, give or take, 10 to 20 years on here. What we found, and urologists quote this all the time, is if we take a man who actually has a very low risk of prostate cancer from Japan, and he's eating relatively healthy, when we say relatively, again, he's probably, hopefully hasn't been, you know, inundated with Kentucky Fried Chicken and McDonald's over in Japan, and then he moves over to the United States, within about 20 years, his risk of developing prostate cancer is going to be very similar to the average American. And again, the prostate cancer is higher, it's a higher risk in Caucasian men as well as African American men in the United States. So why is that? Is it just because we all live next to train stations or we get exposed to benzene? And the answer is no. It's for a number and a whole host of reasons. Environmental is going to be one of it. But what we found is that one of these issues is diet. Okay, what is the diet issue? Well, one thing we do know with diet is that men from a fatty diet, so we've got, here's how we break it down. So we've got fats, proteins, carbohydrates. It's important that the fats that those patients have, and anybody or man for that matter, hopefully you're not a patient yet, those fats are not, again, trans fats are terrible. We're trying to keep those fats relatively low in terms of the big steaks and the red meat. What happens with these is that if you take the inflammatory processes that actually go into a lot of the steaks that are made, and we talk about, you know, grain-fed, you know, and corn-fed beef and things, that actually, what happens is those inflammatory cytokines, you're actually eating those, and technically you are what you eat. And what's happening is that that's causing transformations inside your body. We actually know that if you overcook your steaks, what'll happen is you denature those proteins. Everything you put into your body has to then say, it's like a factory. It says, okay, I'm going to take this good food and I'm going to process it. Okay, I'm going to take this Twinkie and I have no idea what the hell to do with this thing. So I'm going to put it over on the side, and then it puts over in the bad part of the factory. And then that factory all goes haywire. You get a bunch of workers that all go on strike. And guess what happens? Bad things happen. And bad things happen by the mean that you get inflammatory processes. Inflammation causes more reactions in the body that your body doesn't want. And as a result, long-term wise, you're not going to get prostate cancer from eating a Twinkie. You might grow a third ear, and that's no good, but it's not going to happen overnight. This is a thing that happens time after time. The big thing that we look at, again, it's not just the red meat issue, unless, of course, you're overcooking it. We got to think about carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, sort of the mean, you know, like the we talk about the bad carbohydrates, things that actually raise your insulin level. So if I decide to drink a Coke and all of a sudden I get all that sugar, what does that sugar do? It causes my pancreas to go, man, I got to bind that sugar and I got to make sure I actually get that sugar. And what happens is only a certain amount of sugar is there and you get those insulin spikes. So the big thing we worry about is carbohydrate and insulin spikes. So now we're going to go over to proteins. And proteins, for the most part, if you're cooking the proteins, you know, reasonably well, we talked about some of the meats and the fishes and things like that. We want to make sure that actually people are eating legitimate and good proteins. So what do I tell people? I say, okay, well, that's a great little snippet on you know, what to eat, but you know, where do I go from here? A lot of men have embraced what's called the Mediterranean diet, which is really not eating a lot of meats, and it's eating a lot of, you know, grains and things along those lines. I would actually tell you that although I don't think that's a terrible diet, you can still actually get those insulin spikes. Personally, I actually like the paleo, but I like paleo with not so much meat. The paleo is the Paleolithic diet, which is basically you eat like a caveman, but you actually were eating a lot of vegetables and you know, things you would actually get off the land. We want to decrease that inflammation. So what I tell patients is think paleo-like, which is think about proteins, veggies, maybe a little bit of fruits, and a little bit of nuts. And that's it. Don't eat anything out of a box. Be careful when you go out to eat. Don't eat off the menu. Try to make sure that, you know, if they say, hey, I've got this, Jack Steak Surprise, go, listen, that's great. Give it to that guy. I want to make sure that I'm eating something, you know, if it's going to be Jack Steak, it's a good steak, preferably if it's grass-fed, which again, can be tough to find. And again, try to keep the carbohydrates low. We don't want those spikes in there. If you keep those spikes down, then what happens is your body and your pancreas all kind of stay in this nice line. And if it stays in this nice line, you lose weight, your body functions the way it should. And again, you're not, you know, basically just stuffing Twinkies down there, which is also causing those spikes. Those spikes are a bad thing. Majority of patients, again, when I can put them on these kind of diets, and I'm not saying that paleo is the be-all and end-all, but it's this concept, which is we need to go back to eating whole foods and primarily proteins, veggies, a little bit of nuts, a little bit of fruits.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.